There are two moments that I remember being catalytic. Is that a word? Anyway, all I know is I was in prayer. I was praying, and I was praying a really nice prayer. And the Lord was like, okay, but when are you going to actually tell me how you feel about it? Like, you've told me everything I can do, and how are you going to stand and have faith and believe? But he was like, I want you to be real with me. Like, you still have a loincloth on in my presence. That was the moment that I was like, oh, okay, he's actually about to take me on a journey.
I avoid the grit of life, the responsibility and fight, and my garbage piles so high.
I think that when people know things, they have a choice to make. They can either use what they know to love or be afraid. And so, and choose fear. I hope that makes sense. Like, the things that you know, based on what you know, you have to make a choice. Am I going to love myself, others, the world, whatever? Or am I going to choose fear and operate from that place?
Favorite place?
Oh, I never knew, no, I never knew why. Let me do it again. You weren't recording?
I was just waiting to see what you were gonna add.
So you can't crumple that paper while we recording. Come on, let's do the song.
I'm gonna talk about it later.
I am grateful though. I haven't lived in such a way where I've had a bunch of secrets. I've always kind of been out with how I feel. I'm very vocal. And what I've been like walking through. And so I've never been afraid that I was gonna really get like gotcha caught out there. But it was because I had lived a life that was pretty much like, I'm going to correct myself before anybody can correct me.
Y'all want me to be excited about stuff I'm not excited about. I don't get excited about stuff until after. Like, tonight I'm going to go home and probably cry. But, like, in the moment, I'm not like, oh, like, maybe when I get there, I'll be excited. I'm just hoping somebody will show up. Because that's a real thing in my mind.
At the end of 2020, in November of 2020, the Lord told me to go to therapy. He was like, you need to go to counseling for what's coming next year. And I didn't understand it. I didn't know. But I did. And I went to therapy and I started setting some goals. And as I set the goals, this stuff just started. He started to work on me and chip away at old things and my choices, my reasoning, my logic, all the things.
I won't circle to find a parking spot. I'd rather just pull into a lot. Who cares about the money spent? I'm living in the moment.
So in real life, I am a flight person. I would rather not engage in the fight. But because I have a will that wants justice and wants things to be right, I will fight for justice. And so it really depends. I think sometimes it's like I can get to a point where I'm like up to here and now it's like, oh, now we gotta fight. But my desire, my truest desire is like, get out of here, like run away. Do not deal with it. Avoid, abort, passively, aggressively do some maneuver to get out of here. And maybe they'll know how you feel, but you kind of like, ugh. But I'm learning as I mature that you have to face things and you have to deal with it. It's not just going to go away. That doesn't work. It really doesn't work. And so I'm learning how to fight, but in a peaceful way. I was like, oh no, I don't think I'm good. You know, like, I don't think I'm good. And I hid it. I hid it from others. For a while, I almost hid it from myself.
I'm grateful because I think these songs that are on here now are
exactly what is supposed to be out. I think they're way more honest. The other ones were more religious and not, I'm not talking about like godly, I'm talking about just religious and seeing things through a perspective that I think was very limited and like not real. I was still fronting. Like I still didn't want y'all to know and hear and see all of the things that were going on. I'm still trying to be like your worship leader, you know? And this album is like me being his daughter. It's just me being his kid and being a human and being like your peer, you know?
If it adds more work to what I make, then I'd rather just eat all my meals on a paper plate. Throw it away. Oh, I never knew, no one ever knew why. I've always been so drawn to plastic.
I'm grateful now. I feel like I'm in a space where I'm actually open and vulnerable and asking the Lord to lead me. And I'm not just sitting in the room with my face on the floor. I'm actually out living life and I can see, oh, got work on that. Oh, you're still not fully healed in that area, you know? And before I used to think that that was a bad thing. And now I'm like, oh no, this is an opportunity for me to see God's grace in my life. This is an opportunity for me to grow. This is an opportunity for me to hand some things over to the Father that I've been holding on to tightly or that I've tucked away secretly and even I forgot about. Jesus is like ripping up carpets like, ha, look at that.
So I'm trying to handle my heart in a healthy way. Don't want it to break. Oh, I never knew, no, I never knew why. I've always been so drawn to plastic.
I think that with knowledge comes a lot of responsibility. I feel like I had to unlearn like a lot of things and like look at myself, like really look at myself, like me.